Drop the ego flow, it's time to let it go. Nityanam guys, I welcome you back to this episode, the ultimate series, with my blessings, my respects, my love, and the blessings of my Guru, His Divine Holiness, Bhagwan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam. So, today's episode, an episode I released recently, Drop the Ego Flow, It's Time to Let It Go. Check it out and see the powerful cognition that I'm sharing about the importance of guru-disciple relationship in your life in order to be successful and powerful. In today's episode, I want to bring your awareness to the importance of guru in the experience of Paramashivam, realizing that you are Paramashiva. Parama means ultimate, Shiva means he's the ultimate super consciousness. Shivoham, Oham refers to you. So you are the ultimate super consciousness. That is what it means, Paramashivoham. So the first thing, when we surrender to Guru, we have to cognize Guru as Paramashiva. Shiva says in the Agamas, he reveals in the Agamas, in the scriptures, Hindu scriptures, sacred, secret Hindu scriptures, that he happens in the life of a disciple in the form of a guru. So guru is Paramashiva. And when you cognize Paramashiva with the guru, then the possibility of experiencing Paramashiva becomes available to you. So then the guru, aligning to the guru, will allow you to enter into a space of oneness with the guru. By entering into the space of oneness, automatically your powerless cognitions will be dropped, your ego will dismantle, and then you will enter and, you will experience that space of oneness intensely. And once you do experience oneness with the guru that you cognize as Paramashiva, then automatically the cognition that you are Paramashiva will happen in you, and it will reach the very depth of your existence. And that is how you experience the complete enlightenment, or complete completion, like Swamiji calls it. So that's one important powerful cognition I wanted to share with you about why you have to first cognize that Paramashiva exists, that the space of Paramashivoham is possible. Then you have to align to the Guru, who is the embodiment of that. And by aligning to him, you experience oneness, and through this oneness, you realize your Paramashivoham, and you rise above the ocean of samsaras, like they call it in the Hindu tradition, the ocean of karmas, the endless cycle of life and death, endless cycle of karmas and samsaras. So you rise above that and you live like a Paramahamsa, like a bird who never touched the ground, who hatched. Actually, Paramahamsa is a swan, divine swan, which laid eggs while flying, and before the egg even touched the ground, it burst open, and the baby swan happened and started flying before touching the earth. And that symbolizes being untouched by anything that is worldly, that is powerless, and that is of lower frequency. So you can establish yourself in that space through the oneness with the Guru, through the Guru's grace and the blessings. So with this, I'll see you guys in another episode very soon. Nityanandam. If you like these videos, like, comment below. Any comment will be used to produce other videos. If you have any questions or any perhaps doubt about the guru-disciple relationship, write it down below and I will address it in another video. And of course, subscribe to the channel to know what's up and when it is happening, and click that bell icon. So I'll see you guys soon. Nityanandam once again.